I've had some really good questions, people asking what is cold current and what is it good for. So cold current is an effect that was noted and discovered by a man called Monsieur Richard Vial. And this researcher, technician, discovered this effect, and he decided to call this current, cold current. And the reason why he called it cold current is because on this side here, we've just a function generator and a coil on top of this copper pipe. And this side here, this is classical physics, where you have hot energy going through, so you have a Joule effect. So there is a friction or heat happening in the wire. So this is causing heat in the system. But what was researched and found over 25 years of research is that there is no Joule effect going in this side of the demonstration test. It's more like a test device, if you like. So it's a version one prototype where it was created just to as a proof of concept. So we know a little bit what is cold current. We know that cold current, basically, there's no Joule effect happening in this side of the wire. Explain it a little bit more as to what is cold current, I'm only gonna say what I've read from the papers, and then if you want to know more, I'll add in the video description some links to reports of Jean-Louis Naudin, who's a researcher also, and he's made an extensive report on what's happening here, l'effet Vial, or cold current. There are also physicists and researchers and technicians who have also written papers on academia with their theory, l'effet Vial. So if you go on academia and you search for l'effet Vial, you will find a lot of paper related to this theory of what is happening. But I'm going to give you a little bit more information as to what is happening. Is the side here, when the magnetic field builds up, the researchers have discovered that this is actually a scalar magnetic field that is building up on those sides. And the second element that is occurring, or the second thing that is occurring in the system, is that the copper itself is releasing free electrons. So the free electrons with the scalar magnetic fields create this cold current effect. The key here of this system is that piece of plastic here that Monsieur Vial discovered, and it cuts the path for the cold current to go back, if you like, and stay in this area. So it's sort of a way to force the cold current or the fields to build up on that side and come back on the other side here. So that's what is cold current. I'll put some links in the video description to read a lot more about it. There are books written about this, I've given you the simple answer. So those are quantum fields happening in front of us. There was another question asking if the black wire is disconnected, the light intensity would get brighter. And well, it's exactly the opposite, actually. The black wire is actually required for the brightness of the light to go brighter. So I'm going to show you this. So here the black wire is disconnected. So what we have here is just a black and red wire, but it's really just mostly black wire. that goes to this inductor, and then the inductor is connected back to the black wire here, which then goes back to the connection of the copper pipe. So I'm going to turn the light off, I'm going to zoom in, I'm going to show you that the brightness of the light goes brighter when this is connected. It will only ever go slightly brighter because I don't have much voltage, I don't have much power going in the system. But it's just to show you that there is more power going to the light bulb when we connect the black wire. So hopefully you can see that. I'm going to connect it now. Here we go. Disconnected, connected, disconnected, connected. So we can see that there is more current going to the light when the actual wire is shorted. So this is what I wanted to show you. I had a question asking, what is this energy good for? Well, this energy is the energy of tomorrow. I probably sound like a scratched record disc because this energy was mentioned in the papers over 25 years ago. And 25 years ago, it says it would be the energy that we use in the year 2000. Ironically, and I think it just takes time for the community and everyone to sort of accept discoveries, and because now we've accepted that scalar wave have been proven, replicated, they exist. I think the public is more open-minded to understand that, okay, so we know scalar fields exist, we know scalar wave exists, we know scalar magnetic field exists. So suddenly now it's more comprehensible what's happening here, and it makes much more sense nowadays to actually go ahead and use this kind of energy rather than using the hot energy. There are a lot of benefits of using this kind of energy. It's up to you to actually read the papers and understand what of amazing benefits are available to use this energy. I'm only here just really to introduce you this information and those discoveries because they're just too important to be forgotten. We need to replicate those as much as we can. We need to talk about those as much as we can, this cold current, we need to help increase awareness and understanding that this is the technology we need to go and start using.